Welcome to episode 370, Wang Xing, father of China Web 2.0 and app everything. This is an outline of episode 370. There are three reasons why we study Wang Xing. First, at age 39, Wang Xing is one of the youngest and most successful internet billionaire in China. Second, he's the co-creator of China Everything app, Meituan-Dianping, with over 320 million users. Third, he's the father of China Web 2.0. So, what is China Web 2.0? Let us meet Wang Xing. He is talking about Web 2.0 in China.
That has Web 2.0 in China really transformed internet culture? Has it changed the way that young Chinese people consume media in China?
Yeah, I think the essence of Web 2.0 in China is to make things easier. So for microblogging sites, we make it easy for people to post whatever in their mind. So just a short message from their cell phone or from their instant message like QQ or MSN or Google Talk or just from a web browser. So it is so easy that people who don't like to write a traditional long blog like to write short blogs like mini blog, microblogging. Actually, it's quite easy, so people do it day and night from everywhere, every place, and anytime.
Wang Xing was born in Longyang, China in 1979. His father is a businessman. He's a Mac of Longyang. In 2001, he graduated with a degree in electrical engineering from Tsinghua University, one of the most famous university in the world. He then won a scholarship to study at the University of Delaware. And in 2003, he earned a Master of Science degree in computer science. Then he took the brave step. He dropped out of the PhD program and returned to China to pursue his dream to be an internet entrepreneur. The year was 2004. He was 25 years old. I call him the father of China Web 2.0 because more than anyone else, he shaped the development of Web 2.0. He started 5 internet businesses, succeeded in 2. I won't talk about his failures here, only his successes. RenRen was the first internet company he started in China. He sold it for $2 million when he ran out of cash.
Also, on other social networking sites like Hainan, we allow people not only to write text messages, but also upload photos from their cell phone, from web browsers. So I think if we make it easier enough, people, much more people will do it. And it will generate content, although those content are very low quality from a professional aspect, like my sister's kiss photo, then it will be very important for me. So this way, I think people are spending more and more time on content generated by their friends. That's what I see.
And is there commercial value in that? Is there a way, how has the monetization gone in that regard? Have we found the right business model to monetize these things yet?
Yeah, I wouldn't say so.
Yeah, that's a good.
He sold RenRen for $2 million, and RenRen went IPO in 2011 without him. He had lost the big fish. He started Meituan in 2010. It was a clone of Groupon's, and it quickly caught fire. In just 5 short years, Meituan totaled 200 million users in 2015. Now the breakthrough in 2015, when Meituan merged with Dianping, a diner evaluation site. Dianping was developed by Jiang Tao, a UPenn Wharton MBA from the United States, who returned to China after graduation.
And from Thursday, it's also making investors money. The company has just floated on Hong Kong's stock exchange, and shares have soared, valuing the company at around $55 billion.
After early development, we've established a firm foothold as a market leader, serving a wide range of customers and businesses. We believe this will continue to improve and further expand our value, and we're confident markets will recognize that.
The IPO in Hong Kong created 2 self-made billionaires, Wang Xing with $5.5 billion and Jiang Tao with $1.5 billion. With more than 300 million users, Meituan-Dianping is called the China Everything App.
It's called China's Everything App, and around 350 million people use it. Meituan-Dianping will deliver your food, let you review your meal, sell you tickets for the cinema afterwards, and then drive you home. While Meituan is looking more and more popular among consumers, its business model still has big question marks hanging over it. The company lost more than $3 billion in the first 4 months of this year, despite a big jump in revenue. That's more than its total losses of about $2.8 billion in 2017. Meituan also faces growing competition on the Chinese mainland from a company called Elemi. That's backed by Alibaba, while Tencent owns a big stake in Meituan, adding another dimension to the turf war between China's biggest tech giants.
Meituan-Dianping got a really strong group of cornerstone investors. So Tencent is already an existing backer of Meituan, and they were a cornerstone. And they were also able to get some big name funds, such as Oppenheimer funds, to back them. So that has looked, that has been quite encouraging so far. So the IPO really gained quite a lot of institutional demand.
It also bodes well for Hong Kong's stock market and the big list of companies waiting to debut on the exchange.
Wang Xing, still 39, is the new generation of internet startup that has changed China, and maybe the world one day.
Over the past 5 years, China has embraced a life online. Some expats here in China, as well as Chinese themselves, have dubbed the phenomenon China's four new great internet innovation. Same as the four old inventions, it is their new technology that transforms people's lives. One of these four, and the one that appears to be floating Thomas's boat, is mobile payment, in which China is now leading the world in scale, scope, convenience, and coverage. So,
thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. My next video will be Wang Xing, from China Web 2.0 to Internet Plus, 8 lessons. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.